Andy with you for Nail Guitar. Once again, we've got Mr. James Steelger in the studio. We did a bit of an interview. This is sort of part two that we're continuing on from here. And we're going to look at something that you're quite knowledgeable with, which is getting funding for your recording. For a lot of people, it's saving your pennies for months and months and months, especially in a situation of doing a solo project, which you have. How are you going to cover it all yourself?
Yeah, you can't split the cost, exactly. Yeah.
So there is funding options out there, and that's what you're going to talk about. James has basically managed to get some grant support through, it's government grants, yeah?
Yeah, Arts Tasmania.
Arts, yeah.
So they run a program every year where there's a pool of money, musicians, dancers, whatever your art project is, or whatever your field is. If you've got a good project, well, even if you have a bad project, you can still apply, but you've got a better chance if it's
marketed well. As long as it's marketed well to them.
Yeah. So if you've got an idea for a project in one of those sorts of, or in an artistic field, you can apply for funding for that. So obviously you have to have it all costed out.
Yep.
You've got to have, there's a lot to it. It's not a simple process. It's not just, I want to go on tour around Australia for the next 6 months, so I'm going to, can you give me some money?
Yeah.
You've got to have a lot of things lined up. You've got to have letters of support and all those sorts of things. So in my case, it was making an album.
Yep.
As you said, whereas in bands, you can split the cost three ways, four ways, five ways when you're by yourself. You've got the whole lot to pay for. So my idea with this album was I wanted to do something a bit different to previous recordings.
Yep.
And that was to get some guys in who I'd built up contacts with over the years, just from playing and doing shows and all that sort of thing. So who I'd built up contacts with who were playing at a lot higher level than I was. So get those guys to see if they come play my record and maybe get a better sounding record. I guess go up a level from what I'd done previously. That was more than anything. How do I make the best sounding record I could possibly make?
Yep.
And how much is it going to cost me? So in that instance, I was able to get, Russell, who plays drums in UMI, so an Australian band, for any people that aren't familiar with that.
Yep.
John Auer, who is a Seattle musician who played in a group called the Posies, and also Big Star.
Yep.
And so I'd known Russell for a while. John did mix the last record for Soul Stickers.
Yep.
And through John, we were able to get Stephen McDonald, who plays bass in a group called Red Cross and also in Off. But he's also done a lot of session work, so he toured with Beck.
Yep.
He played bass on the Tenacious D album.
Yeah, cool.
So those guys, this is their bread and butter. This is what they do.
So you either had contact with them or they were a contact of the contact.
Yeah, exactly.
Yep.
So it wasn't so much a case of cold calling, hey, I've got all this money, can you come and... It was a case of saying, oh, I'm going to make a record. Would you be interested?
Yep.
Yes. And then B, I can afford to pay you. How do we... Yeah. So if you're interested, great. What do you charge? Then this is how I'm going to pay you.
So for anyone wanting to go this model, you're putting together a solo album, that sort of thing. Well, not a solo album, but you are a solo figure writing the material, then you want to get the band together. Obviously, you've built up to that of you've had bands in the past, you've made contacts.
Yep.
So as you said, it's not cold calling people. So...
Yeah.
There you go. If something that you want to do, maybe, you know, maybe it's further down the track for some people. If you're 18, you're not going to be necessarily have those contacts of other people. Maybe, you know, it might be, you know, another person in the same city who you really like the work of. Yep. You can potentially get them in on the action. Yep. But at the end of the day, people's time is valuable to them. So that equals you've got to have some sort of exchange of value, which is money.
Yeah. And so, I think it was also a case of, were the songs that I was writing going to be of an acceptable standard as well?
Yep.
So if the songs had been rubbish, I don't think it would have mattered how much money I had. These guys wouldn't have played on them.
Well, it's a matter of taste as well, isn't it? Yeah. I mean, you know what sort of things they've played in, so you've got a reasonable assumption, okay, they've played in this sort of band. Is my material anything like anything they've done before? Then you've got a reasonable assumption of they'll probably like it because...
It's in their ballpark.
Yeah, it's in the ballpark.
Yep, definitely.
The grant process, all that sort of thing, it's something that I've looked at a little bit before, and I know probably one of the biggest put-offs is the lead-up time. For a lot of grants, you've got to apply for the year coming, so a lot of people will get there and go, okay, we're going to record an album, okay, let's rehearse for a month, and then let's go into the studio. With this, you've got to be thinking the next year ahead, don't you?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So it's not a case of, I've got these songs, I need to record them next you know, the next month, I've got this great band. You've got to plan well ahead.
Mm.
In this case, mine was at least 12 months. And obviously I'm a bit older, so I'm not in that much of a rush. I know that this is the songs I'm going to write. They can sit there for 12 months, two years. We'll get them right.
Yep.
Then we'll put them out. And then we'll do the things, tour, all those sorts of things. But it was a case of, I started getting my documentation ready in February.
Yep.
They had to be submitted by, was it April or August? I'll have to double check that anyway.
Yeah.
So it was a good...
Months. We're talking months.
Yeah.
And then you've got to think ahead.
The grants get announced in November.
Yep.
So you get your money in November. So you're right, 9 months at least sort of thing. So you get your money in November.
Yep.
And then you've got to have everything done within a 12 to 18 month period.
Yeah.
So you do your album in the following. So it's that preparation. Mm. And for me personally, it paid off because the quality of product at the end was by far and away the best sounding and all those sorts of things.
That's the reward.
Yeah. So if you're looking for a quick, get sneak an EP out.
Yeah.
You've got to have a plan.
It's funny, there's two sides to it, because on one hand, people can go, you can get thousands of dollars to make music.
Yeah.
And that's so cool and it sounds so easy, but it's actually really difficult. But on the flip side as well, I know lots of people who have been scared off from pursuing grants because it seems so difficult. So on the flip side of the coin, what is easier about it than most people expect?
Hey, thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate your likes and comments. Don't forget to subscribe for more. For heaps more free training, check out my other channels. If you're on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter, be sure to follow me for updates.